This is Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Thanks for tuning in. Today, I want to talk about a very interesting study that's a little bit off what I normally talk about. Usually, I talk about nutrition, etc. This is actually to do with AIDS. When I trained in medical school in the mid-1990s, AIDS was a very significant disease and people were all dying of it. There wasn't any good treatment. Now we move on to 15 years later and there's actually some excellent treatments with some new drugs that will really make AIDS not a disease you'll actually die from unless you're in the third world in Africa. However, what's fascinating is this study that was just published in the Journal of the American Medical Association was actually done in Botswana, Africa. With AIDS, the disease, the virus attacks the immune system. And the most important thing is the thing called the CD4 cells. They orchestrate, they organize the immune system. And with AIDS, there's an attack on those specific cells so that your immune system just crumbles. The way we treat HIV is we look at the levels, and if your levels of your CD4 count are normal, you don't need any medicine. Your immune system is still working. However, if your CD4 count starts to drop, then you're developing actual AIDS, and that's when we start to treat you. What they did in this study is they took 800 plus people from Botswana, and they divided them in half, and they gave half just their regular follow-up, and the other half they gave selenium and a multivitamin. And then they followed them, and they followed what happened to their CD4 counts. What they found was absolutely amazing. If you were on just selenium, 200 micrograms, and a plain, good old-fashioned multivitamin, and you were in Botswana, if you took that every day, your risk of actually dropping your immune count, of your CD4 count going so low you needed to start medicine, was half that of the people who weren't on anything. So my take on this is that a multivitamin is not a bad thing. I know there's some argument about whether it's good or bad, but clearly it seems to be having some health effect, and I think it's something worth taking every day. Dr. Joe Feuerstein with the MD Minute. Namaste.